Stolen elections have catastrophic consequences.
Steve Bannon sticking to the big lie of a stolen election on his podcast Friday, the same day he was slapped with two counts of contempt of Congress. The charges stem from Bannon's refusal to cooperate with an investigation into the January 6th attack on the Capitol. The committee wants to know about his actions before and during the riot, including talks with then-President Trump and comments Bannon made prior to the attack.
All hell is going to break loose tomorrow.
Bannon has said he's following Trump's orders not to talk, citing executive privilege, even though he didn't work for the White House at the time. Today, in a statement, Trump said, "This country has perhaps never done to anyone what they have done to Steve Bannon."
This is an important step for the Department of Justice.
Congresswoman Zoe Lofgren is on the committee that subpoenaed Bannon. Now, former White House Chief of Staff Mark Meadows is also refusing to cooperate.
Bannon and now Meadows appear to believe that they're above the law.
Meadows didn't show up for a deposition on Friday.
When ultimately witnesses decide, as Meadows has, that they're not even going to bother showing up, that they have that much contempt for the law, then it pretty much forces our hand and we'll move quickly.
On Monday, Bannon is expected to turn himself in to the authorities, followed by his first court appearance. Experts say the fact that it got to this stage is rare.
A lot of people initially refuse to comply with congressional subpoenas. They always end up, normally at least, negotiating their way out of it, coming to a deal, and giving something less than was originally sought.
If Bannon were to be found guilty, he could face fines and a year of jail time for each count. Magda Gebrselassie, CBC News, Washington.